In this tutorial, you can check how to apply moving load on a bridge structure. This bridge structure is a general four-span reinforced concrete voided slab. And the moving load will be general truck load, which can be edited by the moving load editor. It's a predefined moving load. You can modify the position of the loads, increase it, redefine it, or the truck dimensions, or you can just modify the axle loads. It can be a crane type load, which is not valid here. You can choose the bridge type. In this case, load can surpass the domain. The load path can be applied under domain along lines. It can be a straight line. It can be multiplied straight lines, and the number of load steps can be adjusted as well. You can always check the moving load before proceeding further. The moving load can be dragged around to place in the right lane on the bridge. And then the analysis can be run. You can see the deflection diagram first in each load steps. Then you can see how the structure behaves, or you can check the reaction forces the graphical way. Together with the deformed shape of the structure. As you have a virtual beam on the structure defined, you can check the bending moments in the structure, which can be used for design purposes. Or as you have an eccentric load, you can check the torsional moments in the bridge. You can modify the load and add a secondary one. It will be another one, same truckload with the same load steps, same bridge type, but the load path will be different. So now you have one moving load in one lane, and the other moving load in the other lane. These two are independent of each other. You can rerun the analysis. The new load expresses the same type of bending moments in the bridge, and any other internal forces can be just checked the same way. Now you want to see the envelope diagram of these load cases. You create an envelope diagram which includes all load steps of first one. You include only the second moving load in this envelope, and you create another one where only the first one will be included. And here's the envelope diagram minimum and maximum, and the same figure for the moving load. You can check the maximum value. Which, as you can see, happens in this load step. So you want to combine this governing moving load step with the dead load of the bridge. You add the dead load. And then you create a combination where you have partial factor for the dead load. Then you come here to the right with slow steps, add the load factor on it which you want. And in this case you have a load combination, which combines the governing moving load step and the dead load of the bridge. Run the analysis again. Here you can see shear force, bending moment for this load combination with the dead load and the governing load step. With AXISVM software, there is no limit you can make.